Hi, and welcome to my new video about what is deploy in the context of the Safe for DevOps Health Radar. Please note that everything that I'm going to say and everything that I'm going to show you is under the license of Scaled Agile. Please also note that the Scaled Agile framework is a framework. Use it as a toolbox. Take out of this toolbox what fits your needs and what solves your problem. In my previous videos, we had a look at the Safe for DevOps Health Radar. We started with the hypothesis. In this step, we transfer all of the bright ideas into a hypothesis statement and we put them into epics. Then we went into collaborate and research. We analyzed this hypothesis statement, we went to the customer, analyzed the customer needs and also the market needs. After that, we went into architect. We analyzed what would be the minimal architecture which we can create to prove this hypothesis. In the synthesize step, we then broke down the epic into features, which we then put onto the program backlog. In the develop step, we take one of these features, break the feature down into user stories, and then we start coding this feature. We then commit the code into the source code repository, and then we build a deployable package. This is what we do in the build step. After the build step, we go with the deployable package, deploy that into a staging environment and start the end-to-end testing. Now, let's have a look what we are doing in the deploy step. In the deploy step, we want to continuously deploy our changes into the production environment. Why are we doing this? Because by continuously deploying our changes into the production environment, we are able to do that with a low risk and a high frequency. Why is that possible? Because when we only do small changes, then these small changes have a lower risk of failing when we put them into the production system. When we have changes which have accumulated over, for example, 3 months, then these changes are much bigger and have a much higher risk. So that's why we want to continuously deploy our changes with a high frequency and a low risk into the production system. To continuously deploy into the production system, we need to separate deployment from release. A deployment is bringing the compiled code into production with the feature switch off. A release is switching the feature switch on in the production environment. Distinguishing between deployment and release enables us to continuously deploy into production. Perhaps you remember that we have already discussed separating deployment from release in the architect step, which you can see in this video up here. It is important that when we are architecting a system, that we are already architecting so that we can separate deployment from release. To enable us to separate deployment from release, we need to have feature toggles or feature switches. With feature toggles, we are able to switch on and switch off features. A feature toggle is nothing else than an if statement. If flag is set, send an email. If flag is not set, then print out the document. Please be careful when introducing feature toggles. Each one of these feature toggles is a test. If you have multiple of these feature toggles, you get a lot of things that you need to test. Also note that the feature toggle must be removed when you have released the feature. A feature toggle is not the same as an application configuration. An application configuration is something that will stay for a long time because you can configure the application. A feature toggle is only there to enable us to continuously deploy into the production with the feature toggle off and then release it and switch on the feature toggle. Then we will remove the code of this feature toggle. Separating deployment from release and having the feature toggles enables us to have dark launches. Doing dark launches enables us to test already the monitoring and also the alerting in the production environment. We are also already able to see how the newly defined code acts in production with the real production data. When we want to continuously deploy into production, we of course need to have everything under version control. And when I say everything, I mean everything. It's not only the code, it's also the infrastructure configuration, all of the tests, the test data, the requirements, the architecture, everything. Because when we have everything under version control, we are able to do, of course, rollbacks, but we are also able to investigate very fast the problems that we potentially have in production because we know exactly what has been deployed and what has changed to the previous version. And perhaps remember that version control was already a topic in the develop step and we have covered that already there. When we want to continuously deploy into production, we of course also need to have a look at the infrastructure. Infrastructure as code enables us to have an automated environment set up. We do that by having the configuration of our infrastructure, how the infrastructure should look like in a configuration file. These configuration files are of course stored in the version control. By using tools like Chef, Puppet and so on, we are able to automatically set up via infrastructure as code our infrastructure. This has the big advantage that we can save costs, we are faster and we can lower the risk because by having infrastructure as code, we always have the same setup for our infrastructure. When we want to continuously deploy to production, we of course also need to automate all the steps which are needed to bring our compiled code into production. This is the deployment automation. And also with the deployment automation, it is important that the developer always gets feedback about failed or successful deployments. If we are not allowed to fully automatically deploy to production, then we are able to do a self-service deployment. This is also known as the push the button deployment. In that case, the deployment is still fully automated, but the trigger when to deploy to the production system is always given by a person by pushing a button. This push a button deployment or self-service deployment is usually necessary in regulated environments where we need to have a segregation of duty. By using selective deployments, we are very flexible when it comes to releasing, because with that we are able to, for example, go with a deployment only in one geographic region or in only in one data center or in one server cluster or in one network segment. This enables us to lower the risk and have more flexible releases. Another practice which we use when it comes to deployment are the blue-green deployments. We already talked about blue-green deployments when we talked about staging. Yes, of course, you can use blue-green deployments in the staging environment, which is the production near environment. But of course, you can also use that in the production environment. When we do a blue-green deployment in production, we have two identical production environments. One is live, here the green one, and one is idle, here the blue one. The users are using our current version of the product here in the live environment, which is the green one. Because all of the users are using the software on the live environment, the green one, we are able to use the idle one, the blue one, to deploy the next version of our software. Now that we have deployed the next version of our software to the blue environment, we can already test our deployed software in the blue environment and see if everything is okay without affecting all of the users which are still working on the green or the live environment. When everything is good, we can just switch the load balancer to use the blue environment, which then becomes the live environment, and the green environment then becomes the idle environment. In that case, all of the users will switch to the blue environment and they can already use the new version of our software. In case something doesn't work, we are always able to switch back very fast to the green or here the idle environment with the previous version on it. Of course, this sounds very easy and amazing, but this is also not a silver bullet and it also comes with a price tag. You need to have two full production environments on one hand. On the other hand, this approach is quite easy when you only have, for example, functions or code which is stateless. Then it's quite easy. In the case you have a state, in the case you have a database or something else, then this approach becomes difficult and needs architecture and design. So, we have now talked about all of the practices that we can use to continuously deploy to production, but what exactly is the output of continuously deploying it to production? It's quite simple. The output is that we have deployed our changes into the production environment and they are ready to get used. Of course, there are many tools which support us in continuously deploying to production. Again, we have the periodic table of DevOps tools. To be able to continuously deploy to production, we of course need to have a source control management tool where we can store all our artifacts. Here is the list of these tools. To continuously deploy to production, we of course need to have deployment automation. Here you can see all of the tools which support the deployment automation. And of course, when it comes to continuous deployment, we are not only automating the deployment, we are also automating the infrastructure. And when it comes to automating infrastructure, we have the configuration automation, which you can see down here. The Safe for DevOps Health Radar is also an assessment. You can download the assessment under this link as an Excel file. The deployment is the actual migration of features into the production environment. Because the continuous delivery pipeline separates deployment from release, deployed features are not assumed to be live to end users. Rate your team's ability to continuously deploy features to production, as well as the ability to control their visibility using feature toggles and or other means. You are set when features are deployed to production every 3+ months. Deployments are manual and painful. Deployed implies released. And UR crawl, when features are deployed to production at PI boundary, which is a 3 months cycle, deployments are mostly manual. Deployed implies released. And UR walk, when features are deployed to production every iteration. Deployments are mostly automated. Some features can be deployed without being released. And UR run, when features are deployed to production every iteration and fully automated through the pipeline. Dark releases are common. And UR fly, when features are deployed continuously throughout each iteration. Dev teams initiate deployments directly via pipeline tools. Release is completely decoupled from deployment. Dark releases are the norm. With the deployment, we want to be able to deploy our changes with a high frequency and with a low risk into the production environment. And to do that, we need to separate deployment from release and use feature toggles. And with that, we are at the end of this video. Please leave me a thumbs up if you liked this video, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel because I will create every week a new video for you.